I refuse to accept that the shackles of slavery can ever be more stronger than the quest for freedom. I refuse to accept here.
A 14-year-old girl and a 10-year-old boy are lured for a better life, good education and work. They're brought to some other city from their home while in transit and then at the destination area. Both the boy and the girl are exploited multiple times. They are made to do normal chores. They're also made sexual advances at. At the destination area, the boy is employed to clean the gutters in the city and the girl is kept as a domestic aide. For some years, they do the same work for more than 16 hours a day. They are paid almost nothing and are given stale food to eat. As they grow older, the girl is sold for sex work and the boy is put into pornography. One day, a customer calls Childline at 1098. Childline NGO, along with the police, comes to rescue the girl. The girl then also leads the NGO to the boy. The NGO then takes them to the hospital for medical examination, the report of which is submitted to the Child Welfare Committee for further action. Meanwhile, the children are put at a children's home while their case is being investigated. Just like this, many more children have been rescued. But can we prevent people from falling into such traps in the first place? Also, are these children free from the risk of getting re-abducted? Are they truly free?
Azadi ek ishwariya bardan hai. हम आज़ाद पैदा हुए, हमारे हाथ पांव चलाने की आज़ादी, हमारे रोने की, चीखने की, बोलने की आज़ादी, हम दूसरों से मांग करते हैं। छोटा सा बच्चा भी रोकर अपनी माँ से दूध की मांग करता है, ये आज़ादी की शुरुआत है। फिर सीखने की आज़ादी, आगे बढ़ने की आज़ादी, खेलने कूदने की आज़ादी, अपने लिए फैसले लेने की आज़ादी, अपने लिए सरकारें बनाने की आज़ादी, अपने लिए बोलने की आजादी, अपने मर्जी से कोई मत, मजहब, संप्रदाय, धर्म मानने की आजादी, ये सारी आजादियां हमें या तो परमात्मा ने दी हैं, प्रकृति ने दी हैं, हमारे संविधान ने दी हैं, हमारे कानूनों ने दी हैं, लेकिन इस आजादी से उलट जब कुछ बच्चों को, महिलाओं को, पुरुषों को गुलाम बनाया जाता है, उनसे आजादी छीन ली जाती है, तो ये संविधान का, कानून का, प्रकृति का, ईश्वर का, सबका अपमान है, जिसके खिलाफ आपको और मुझे, हम सबको लड़ना है और जीतना है।
What is it like when our freedom is taken away? What is it like to be exploited emotionally, mentally, physically and sexually under the pretext of love, marriage or job? Who gives anybody the right to violate anybody's dignity? So are we free? Or are we slaves in this free world? Or are we slaves despite being free? Buying and selling of human beings for the purpose of exploitation is human trafficking, also known as slavery. It is easy to believe that human trafficking is only related to sex work, but in reality, this term refers to exploitation of any kind. For cheap labor, for organ trade, and for sex.
We really need to understand that traffickers do not care what our religion is, what our caste is, or what our educational background is. We also need not be from a lower socioeconomic class to be trafficked. It cuts across all the genders and classes of our society. Men, women, girls, boys, anybody can be trafficked. Therefore, there is very high possibility that it can happen with any one of us.
Not only public, but even law enforcement officials also, many of them think, even today, that trafficking is prostitution. It is not. Trafficking is taking away a human being from one place to another place, maybe in the same village, maybe in the same community itself, need not be going a long distance. And the person is exploited and exploited commercially. Exploited commercially. So somebody makes money out of exploitation of a human being, that is trafficking.
I think there's several forms of human trafficking. The most common, or the one that we know about most usually and we hear about most, is sex trafficking. But there is also organ trafficking, and there's also labor trafficking. And actually, that's the biggest one. Out of all human trafficking, 68% is labor trafficking, forced labor trafficking. So, you know, it includes a lot of women and children. Over 50% is women and children. And it's a big problem around the world.
Human trafficking takes many forms, including, but not limited to, sexual exploitation in the form of prostitution, forced marriage or child marriage, labor exploitation in the form of forced labor, bonded labor, domestic servitude or begging, exploitation for medical purposes like organ transplantation or commercial surrogacy, sports sex tourism, and military use of children, popularly known as child soldiers. Clearly, there is no limit to the rise of this crime, and it is taking more monstrous forms every day throughout the world. It has visible linkages to critical development issues like poverty, unemployment, illiteracy, gender bias, and lack of awareness, among many others.
जब हम ट्रैफिकिंग की बात करते हैं तो ऐसा नहीं है कि वो आइसोलेशन में कहीं पर हो रही है और सिर्फ एक लॉ एंड ऑर्डर प्रॉब्लम है. ट्रैफिकिंग का बहुत ही एक ऑब्वियस सा कनेक्शन है पॉवर्टी के साथ, लोगों के एजुकेशन के साथ, उनकी ज़िंदगी में अभी व्हाट इज़ अवेलेबल टू देम एज ऑप्शंस ऑफ लाइवलीहुड, इवन इंक्लूडिंग थिंग्स लाइक कि कुछ हमारी कल्चरल प्रैक्टिसेस क्या हैं जिनके कारण लोगों की ट्रैफिकिंग होती है. तो ट्रैफिकिंग इज़ नॉट जस्ट कि हमने किसी को कहीं से लिया और कहीं पे ले जाकर बेच दिया. इट हैज़ डीप रूटेड कनेक्शन विद व्हाट इज़ गोइंग ऑन इन डिफरेंट स्पेसेस इन आवर सोसाइटी.
व्हेन इट कम्स टू ऑर्गेनाइज्ड क्राइम्स लाइक ह्यूमन ट्रैफिकिंग, समटाइम्स बीइंग विजिलेंट इज़ नॉट इनफ.
रिसेंटली आई सॉ a very young girl in a mall taking care of another infant, which was obviously a case of child domestic labor, and the girl must have been 8-9 years old. And when I went up to the lady said, oh, this girl is like our daughter, and we treat her like our daughter. So I asked the lady, is she using the same toilet? Is she going to the same school? Is she eating with you on the same table when you are eating? If none of that is true, then why? How can you say that you are treating her as your own daughter? And even if you were to employ her because she is poor, are you paying her the minimum wage, which is about 10,000 rupees? Children are being trafficked because they are the cheap form of labor. But this is happening right there in our homes. It is happening right there in a public space, in a mall. And people are breaking the law. People are involved in trafficking, indulging in trafficking with impunity. And that needs to stop. So when we see something like that happening, we have to raise our voice.
Human trafficking is a transnational organized crime. Traffickers have a strongly knit network that transcends national boundaries. However, irrespective of the distance from the source to the destination area, victims are ruthlessly exploited over and over by people who lure them, people who transport them, those who act as intermediaries, and those who finally use them.
I think the saddest thing is that it's so difficult to even keep track of trafficking. As an ordinary person, you don't hear about it. It's kept very, you know, once in a while we'll see an article in the paper, but it's kept very silent. And that's because a lot of people are making a lot of money out of it. Approximately $160 billion a year, I think, is made on illegal trafficking. So it is a sort of business, a thriving business, and it is something that needs to be tackled both in a government and on a big scale way, but also in a personal way.
It is horrifying to believe that victims of slavery are as young as 5 years old. Many experts believe that this is, however, only the tip of the iceberg.
कौन है ये बच्चे, कौन है ये बच्चियाँ? ये सब हमारी बहनें हैं, ये सब हमारे भाई हैं, ये सब हमारे बच्चे हैं. ये एहसास जब तक हमारे अंदर नहीं होगा, तब तक भारत माता की जय बोलने का कोई अर्थ नहीं है. ये एहसास जब तक हमारे अंदर नहीं आएगा, तब तक तिरंगा लहराने का कोई अर्थ नहीं है. तब तक हमारी संस्कृति की और सभ्यता की बड़ी बड़ी ढींगे मारने का कोई अर्थ नहीं है। अगर हमारी बेटियां इज्जत के साथ स्कूलों के अंदर, कॉलेजों के अंदर, घरों के अंदर नहीं रह सकती, मोहल्लों में नहीं रह सकती, तो हमें अपने आप से पूछना होगा कि गड़बड़ कहाँ है।
When we come across such incidents of ignorance in our lives, our faith in the power of individual action gets weakened. We start thinking that we, as an individual, can do nothing to change the situation. This is not the case. The truth is that we are the problem and only we can be the solution.
अगर हम ये सोचेंगे कि ट्रैफिकिंग एक बहुत ही बड़ा क्राइम है जिसके बारे में हम कुछ नहीं कर सकते हैं, देन आई नो कि हम कुछ भी नहीं कर पाएंगे। लेकिन अगर हमें समझ में आ रहा है कि ये डायरेक्टली हमसे जुड़ा हुआ है, हाउ वी आर एन इनएक्सट्रिकेबल पार्ट ऑफ इट, पर्टिकुलरली व्हेन वी आर लुकिंग एट द ट्रैफिकिंग ऑफ विमेन एंड गर्ल्स, बिकॉज उसका सीधा संबंध हमारी घरों में महिलाओं और बच्चियों का जो स्टेटस है उससे जुड़ा हुआ है, देन आई नो दैट हाउ सो एवर स्मॉल दैट स्टेप मे बी, वी विल बी एबल टू मेक अ चेंज, बिकॉज इफ वी स्टार्ट द चेंज फ्रॉम आवर ओन फैमिलीज, देन दैट्स ऑल्सो गोइंग टू कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट टू द लार्जर चेंज इन माइंड सेट।
नोइंगली और अनोइंगली, वी ऑल आर अ पार्ट ऑफ द सिस्टम विच फ्यूल्स द डिस्ग्रेस दैट ह्यूमन ट्रैफिकिंग इज। We do not even realize how we promote this slavery in our daily lives, like when a child is employed in our home or business, when a domestic help is abused and paid low wages, when an adult is forced to work under inhuman conditions, or when forced sex work flourishes because of us. Our everyday lifestyle choices, including our gadgets, our apparels and accessories, and even our groceries, many a times involve slavery in their supply chains. This problem is thus inextricably linked to us.
There's this wonderful website. It's called Made in a Free World, and it's a great place to kind of become more aware of which businesses having human trafficking and which businesses are not. And it's also got this sort of quiz thing where you can go on it and check your slavery footprint. So you basically fill in all these details about your life, you know, how many clothes you have, shoes, bags, makeup, what you consume in terms of food, and all these questions. You fill up these questions and it gives you an idea of how much you are part of the system, and what your slavery count is, and mine is 47 according to that questionnaire. So we are all involved, and of course it's impossible for us to not buy clothes and products that we need, but at the same time it is possible for us to send out letters to these companies through petitions, and that website makes it really easy for you to do that.
There are two ways of dealing with that. The first is the easiest and the easier option. When I saw a child in a mall, I think 100 other people also saw that child in a mall. It's just that we choose to ignore. We choose to look the other way. We have become desensitized to the issue and we are not even bothered with it. That is what needs to stop, and we need to raise our voice. The second is that we may be guilty of omission. We may not be aware of what is happening, but these things come out sometimes when somebody does an investigative journalistic story, and then it is our duty to respond to that and write to the company.
All of us are part of the solution. If you are not part of the solution, we are essentially part of the problem, because our resilience, our quietness contributes the problem.
When I heard about the issue of human trafficking, it was like, मैं भी बहुत लेम था, मतलब मुझे बिल्कुल पता नहीं था इसके बारे में, इस इशू के बारे में समझ नहीं थी, एंड आई स्टार्टिंग मीटिंग पीपल एंड ऑल, और जब मुझे ये बात पता चली और मुझे लगा कि यार इतनी बड़ी समस्या है, इतनी बड़ी प्रॉब्लम है, और हम में से कोई भी बात करने को तैयार ही नहीं है. लाइक देर आर सम NGOs हु आर वर्किंग, द गवर्नमेंट आर लाइक दे आर डूइंग लिटिल बिट, बट व्हाई नॉट वी, लाइक हम क्यों कुछ नहीं कर रहे.
इवन इफ द पीपल एनस्लेव्ड ट्राई टू कम आउट ऑफ दिस एक्सप्लॉइटेटिव सिचुएशन, वी स्टिग्माटाइज देम. They're not given respectable jobs. Marrying them is considered a taboo. We do not even integrate their children into our community.
तो जो आदमी लेके आया तो वही मेरे सारे पैसा खाया. फिर मुझे घर एक बार लेके गए तो घर लेके जाने के बाद मेरी जो बाप माँ नहीं था, तो मम्मी पापा नहीं था, बहन है उनके घर गई, तो बहन लोग हमें नहीं घर पे लिए, घर से भागा दिए। बोला तुम कहाँ गए थे, कहाँ नहीं गए थे, हम लोग को बेइज्जती हो गया, हम तुम्हें नहीं लेंगे। तो उनके लड़का, उनके आदमी, दीदी घर पे हमें नहीं लिए, घर पे नहीं लेने के कारण फिर मैं उसके साथ 3 दिन होटल में रुक के फिर मैंने वापस आ गई थी दिल्ली में। फिर दिल्ली में 15 साल तक उस आदमी को मैंने कमा की थी।
So are we not contributing to their already exploitative situation? Shouldn't we give them a hand and pull them out of this dirt? Thus, all of us are guilty. If not by association, we are guilty because we either turn our faces the other way or roll our eyes when we see trafficking in work. The question is, how long will it take for us to rise above this ignorance and do what needs to be done?
जब हम ट्रैफिकिंग की बात कर रहे हैं तो हमें कई और चीज़ों के ऊपर फोकस करना पड़ेगा। ऑफ कोर्स विद द प्राइम फोकस ऑन ट्रैफिकिंग, बट डेफिनेटली फोकस ऑन मेनी अदर थिंग्स इंक्लूडिंग अवेयरनेस जनरेशन, लाइवलीहुड, एजुकेशन, what is the economic opportunities that are available to people, because at the end of the day the obvious choice for us is either we keep mopping the floor, as we say, or we really close the tap. Which means when we are talking about trafficking, in addition to rescue and rehabilitation, prevention is a very critical element that we need to focus on.
A 17-year-old girl named Durga was trafficked from West Bengal to New Delhi in India and was forced into sex work. She did not know what was happening with her, but she was being exploited mentally, physically, emotionally, and sexually. One day, a man who had come to avail her services empathized with her and called her family back in West Bengal. So Durga was subsequently rescued. The traffickers were imprisoned to 10 years of rigorous imprisonment, and the brothel from where she was rescued was ordered to be closed. Durga is now back with her family. She's happy. She's independent. She's learning. She's studying. She's also learning vocational skills. The whole point of this story is that this is not just the story of one brave and courageous Durga. We have many, many brave and courageous people waiting for us to lend them a hand and get them out of such exploitative situations. The question for all of us therefore is, how many of us are willing to do so?
We have seen that many people have been saved and many more are being saved each day. Therefore, the fight against human trafficking is not an impossible one. It is just that there are less people fighting this menace. Maybe that is because many of us think that only the social activists or the government can tackle such a complex issue. But the good news is that we too can join this fight.
आप नौजवान हैं, आप जहां जो भी कर रहे हैं, आप ये मानकर मत चलिए कि अगर आपका भविष्य सुरक्षित हो जाएगा तो देश सुरक्षित हो जाएगा, आप सुरक्षित हो जाएंगे। आप अपने करियर को सुरक्षित करके भी सुरक्षित नहीं रह सकते, क्योंकि जिस तेजी से ये बुराइयां हमारे इर्द गिर्द बढ़ रही हैं वो सबके लिए बहुत नुकसानदायक हैं। पहले तो हमारे देश की छवि के लिए, दूसरा हमारे देश की आर्थिक तरक्की के लिए, तीसरा हमारी शिक्षा को बढ़ावा देने के लिए, कहीं ना कहीं गड़बड़ हैं। तो आप चुनिए अपने अंदर का वो इंसान जो दूसरों की मदद करना चाहता है।
The least we can do as producers and manufacturers is to ensure that we do not encourage child labor and we do not encourage forced labor, which means that we give fair wages to all. And this is not an impossible thing to do. We have amazing, inspiring examples in this world to prove this. For example, there is an organization called Terra Organica in Washington, D.C. It is a natural food store supply chain. So they do a very amazing job. One is that they ensure that the products that they buy and sell do not involve slavery in any form. Secondly, they also contribute a part of their profit in anti-human trafficking efforts. So the whole point is that we need the producers and manufacturers to join this fight against human trafficking with us. Because as we all know that majority of human trafficking that happens around the world is for forced labor. Therefore, manufacturers and producers are an inextricable part of this.
When I went to Cochin, the law students asked me, Cochin in a law college, they said, can we think of some innovative idea? I said, waiter, do you have a debating club? Yes. Do you have a yacht club? Yes. Do you have a tennis club? Yes. Can you have a human rights club? I would call AHT club, Anti-Human Trafficking Club. One of the boys said, sir, it's a very wonderful idea. Start off. And he has started off. He asked me, how do you do? I said, just nothing. Two of you get together and say, we have an anti-human trafficking club. We take a decision that we will not violate anybody's rights. Anybody who is willing to take a decision that we will not violate others' rights can join this club. Today, the club has become grown bigger. So this AHT club is one thing. This, I don't say clubs make a difference, but the club is a visible symbol by which you say you are part of the mission.
Each one of us can make a difference every day in a small way, every ordinary person. And that's by signing online petitions about human trafficking.
I wasn't a very firm believer of signing petitions and making petitions to various authorities, but I signed anyway. So the beauty of these sites is that they provide you exact feedback on how you have helped by sending you campaign updates.
Whenever we read about a case of any trafficking, we have to write to the concerned company. We have to make sure that as consumers, we have a right in demanding what kind of products are being offered to us. That is a very important part.
One of the challenges that nonprofit organizations working against human trafficking faces lack of sustained sources of funding, which does not seem to be a problem with the traffickers at all. So I think that corporates can come together with NGOs, not just for funding support, but also to help with their expertise.
The most vulnerable people should be educated. Go to the villages when you get time. Speak to people about their rights, women's rights, how they can be exploited. Make them aware, it can make a difference.
Indian Penal Code itself incorporates under Section 166A a provision that if a public servant is not following the rule of law in dealing with cases of trafficking, including registration of FIR, including proper investigation, then action can also be taken against the public servant, including a police officer, and they may be punished for up to 2 years. So it's a very comprehensive and very efficient law.
आपको लगता है कि कहीं किसी अनजान बच्ची को किसी सड़क पर, किसी ट्रेन में, किसी बस में, किसी प्लेटफॉर्म पर, किसी ऐसी जगह पर जहां आपको लगता है कि कुछ गड़बड़ है, कुछ अज्ञात लोग एक बच्ची को या बहुत सारी बच्चियों को ले जा रहे हैं, तो समझिए कि वहां कुछ ना कुछ दाल में काला है। हो सकता है कि वो लोग ट्रैफिकर हों। थोड़ा सा इंटरेस्ट लीजिए, थोड़ी सी रुचि लीजिए और देखिए कि ऐसे लोग दलाल हो सकते हैं जो आपको दिखता है कि दिल्ली के या पंजाब के या हरियाणा के लोग हैं, और लड़कियां जो उनके साथ आ रही हैं ट्रेन के अंदर या बस स्टॉप के अंदर, वो लड़कियां आपको लग रही हैं कि नॉर्थ ईस्ट की हैं, असम की हैं, नागालैंड की हैं, अरुणाचल की हैं, तो आपको शक हो जाएगा। थोड़ी सी आंखें खोलिए और ट्रैफिकिंग को रोकिए।
सो आई हैव नेवर पर्सनली गॉन आउट एंड फॉर एग्जांपल रिपोर्टेड अ क्राइम ऑफ ह्यूमन ट्रैफिकिंग। हाउएवर I feel that I'm quite aware in terms of the people that surround me, like my maid and my driver and my watchman, you know, to know that their kids are going to school, finding out that, you know, making sure that it's really important and letting them know that, you know, I can support that. I think for me, the most important thing is that kids at least get protected and have that safety.
Trafficking for forced labor is prohibited in a plethora of laws, including the Bonded Labor System Abolition Act, the Child Labor Prohibition and Regulation Act, and the Juvenile Justice Act. The Transplantation of Human Organs Act prohibits the forced removal of organs and trafficking for that purpose. So while on one hand we have one central legislation in the Penal Code itself, which makes it very easy and very efficient for the police and other law enforcement agencies to implement the law, we have a plethora of laws to deal with the other aspects of trafficking that include investigation for attachment of property, that include the rehabilitation framework for the victims of trafficking, and that includes going through the entire supply chain.
I like pages of organizations like Walk Free, Antislavery.org, Global Rescue Relief that are doing a marvelous job in this area. So Samrit, this made me realize the power of social media and the voice that it lends you.
Har ek jo samaj mein hum log ye manushya jeevan leke paida hue hai, har ek insaan ko samaj ke liye kuch dena chahiye. Apna aas pados mein kuch na kuch chalte rehta hai, bacche hai, mahilaen hai, unko hamari zarurat hai. To hum log kisi na kisi tarika se madad kar sakte hai, chahe paise se, chahe kapdon se, chahe पेन, पेंसिल, किताब, स्कूल बैग, कुछ भी, या जूते, चप्पल, कुछ भी दे के मदद कर सकते हैं, और समाज में एक अच्छा नागरिक बनने के लिए हम लोग कहीं ना कहीं थोड़ा सा मदद कर सकते हैं, यही मेरी इच्छा है, सबसे प्रार्थना है समाज का प्रति कुछ करने की ठान लीजिए।
मुझे लगता है कि अगर आप थोड़ा सा भी चेंज कहीं ला पाए, अगर आप 100 लोगों के में नहीं बल्कि 10 लोगों में ला पाए और वो इम्पैक्ट लोगों तक पड़े, वो लोग काम करना शुरू कर दें, तो इससे बड़ी बात कुछ हो नहीं सकती। तो आई थिंक या दैट्स इट, आई एम स्टिल डूइंग इट, आई एम मेकिंग फिल्म्स, आई एम डूइंग प्लेस और बदलाव लाने की कोशिश कर रहा हूँ।
If you have any new or innovative idea to fight against human trafficking, technology related, research related, or any other idea, or you have any queries, suggestions, feedback, or any experience to share, then please feel free to write to us at aht.pankhuri@gmail.com. For further information, you can also visit our blog, aht-freedommatters.blogspot.com.
In a world where our forefathers died to gain freedom, we still allow slavery to go on. Is human trafficking that big a part, or are we that weak?
The time to decide is now. Do we want our inherent spark to die a fluttering death, or do we want to kindle an immortal fire from this spark?
आज कम से कम भारत में आपके पास एक नोबेल शांति पुरस्कार है, वो अकेले मेरे लिए नहीं है, ये हर एक भारतीय के लिए है। और एक भारतीय होने पर गर्व करते हुए आप महसूस कीजिए कि आप अपनी सामाजिक जिम्मेवारी निभाएंगे, और जो बच्चों का बाल व्यापार है, दुर्व्यापार है, लड़कियों का, बेटियों का हमारी जो दुर्व्यापार है, उसको रोकें आप। और कम से कम आपकी पीढ़ी इतना कुछ कर जाए कि आगे आने वाली पीढ़ियां आप पर गर्व करें, आप पर शर्म ना करें, आपके बच्चे इतिहास की किताबों में पढ़ें कि बच्चों की ट्रैफिकिंग, बच्चों की गुलामी एक बुराई हुआ करती थी जिसे हमारे माँ बाप ने ख़त्म कर दिया है। वो गर्व के साथ आपको याद करें, आप ऐसा बन के दिखाइए। बहुत धन्यवाद।
सो वॉट आर वी वेटिंग फॉर? एवरी डे लेट्स टेक वन सिंपल स्टेप अगेंस्ट ह्यूमन ट्रैफिकिंग, बिकॉज फ्रीडम मैटर्स। हो गई है पीर पर्वत से पिघलनी चाहिए, इस हिमालय से कोई गंगा निकलनी चाहिए। आज ये दीवार पर्दों की तरह हिलने लगी, शर्त लेकिन थी कि ये बुनियाद हिलनी चाहिए। हर सड़क पर, हर गली में, हर नगर, हर गांव में हाथ लहराते हुए हर लाश चलनी चाहिए। सिर्फ हंगामा खड़ा करना मेरा मकसद नहीं, सारी कोशिश है कि ये सूरत बदलनी चाहिए। मेरे सीने में नहीं तो तेरे सीने में सही, हो कहीं भी आग लेकिन आग जलनी चाहिए। Thank you.